So, what is up, everyone? It's good to be back with another video, and yeah, we've got a game here called 3 Minutes to Midnight, which is a comedy. It's a comedy type of game. So yeah, let me know what you think about it down in the comments section. And yeah, don't forget to like, comment, share, and subscribe. Tell your friends and tell your family. It's absolutely free, doesn't cost anything. So yeah, with all that being said, let's get started with 3 Minutes to Midnight. Place a cursor over an interactive object and its name will pop up. Press the right mouse button to learn more about it. To talk with a character, position the cursor on them and press the left mouse button. Often you can talk with someone at one point in the game and then return to them later to get new information. Okay. In a conversation, you will have to select what Betty says from the phases at the bottom of your screen. Okay. Press tab to open the dialogue. Navigate with the left arrow back and the right arrow forward. To help you identify interactive objects more quickly, press the H key to highlight them. Pressing the left mouse button will have Betty interact with the object. When Betty picks up or is given an object, the object is added to the inventory. To bring up the inventory, scroll up using your mouse wheel. Examining an object when it's in the inventory, it gives additional information. To close the inventory, scroll down using your mouse wheel. When the cursor changes to this icon, it means that after clicking, Betty will walk to a different location. A double click to make Betty teleport there instantly. Place the cursor over an inventory item and select it with the left mouse button. The cursor will change into the item. For quicker navigation, hold down the shift key while using the mouse wheel to cycle through the items. Move it over objects or characters in the environment and press the left mouse button to use the inventory item with them. Some items can be combined with other items. Select one item, move it over another, and press the left mouse button to combine them. Okay. In a hurry, hold down the left mouse button and Betty will walk faster. Just remember, she won't do it if she's indoors. Pressing the escape key opens the game menu. Just remember, you won't be able to access the game menu while this icon is present in the top right corner.
Bye-bye.
Okay.
Woo! Scarecrow Studio presents... "3 Minutes to Midnight."
Oh. Oh, he's blowing up a dam? Mayor of a forgotten town. Later that night.
Ow, my head. Ugh. What's wrong with me? Mm-hmm. Well, you're looking good, girl.
I like it already.
Why don't I remember anything? Oh, hello? Do you know what's going on?
I don't. Hello?
I guess you don't know either.
Mm-hmm.
Well, anyway, we won't get answers just hanging around.
Okay. Birthday card.
Happy birthday, fool. Honestly, Betty, you should be the one congratulating me for putting up with your crap for this long. Maybe when your mom finally ungrounds you, we can throw a wild party. We both know how much you enjoy cake. Have a wonderful day and all that. Your best and probably only friend, Linda.
Well, Linda's rude.
Friends like these. Anyway, maybe I should find her and see if she's okay.
Yeah, Linda, she's kind of rude. Huh? Rude Linda.
Nothing special. Just a hand mirror.
Oh, what's this? Glue?
Completely normal glue. Trust me. Pinky promise. Cross my heart and hope to die. Eat 1,000 needles if I lie. Betty.
You sure if it's glue? I don't believe you.
A cute little fish with a deep, penetrating stare. Maybe it knows what's going on? Look! A clownfish!
Glub, glub, glub.
Okay. Aren't we a little crabby tonight? Maybe I forgot to feed you.
Aren't we a little crabby tonight? Maybe I forgot to feed you. Anyway, are you going to help me?
Glub.
Glub. What do you know about me?
What do you know about me?
Glub, glub da blub.
Nice try, but you're the one in a bowl, my friend.
Blub, blub.
Does blub. Anybody else live in this house? I mean, do you have any other pets?
Grubby blubby. Glub, glub, glub.
Just me and the old lady from the picture? What picture?
Yeah, what picture? What's your name?
What's your name?
Glub.
Glub.
Huh? Alright, from now on, I'll call you...
We'll call him, Bruce?
Bruce.
I was going to say sushi. That'd have been funny, wouldn't it? We'll call it sushi. Sushi? 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 Did you hear... something outside? What else can you tell me?
What else can you tell me?
Glub, glub, blub. Glub, da blub. Glubby blub.
Wait, you've been watching me sleep this whole time?
Wait, what?
Creepy.
Creepy. Do you know where I... Did you hear something outside? Spin around.
Spin around.
Glubby glub.
Okay. Play dead.
Play dead.
Wow, it's well trained, isn't it? Best fish ever. I actually won this fish at an amusement park.
Jump.
Fully trained. I won it by throwing darts at a card. Glub.
Glub? Maybe my fish is a bit rusty. Use it or lose it, they say.
Any plans for tonight?
Any plans for tonight?
Blub. Blub da blub.
Netfish and chill. What's that?
Blub blub da glub.
Nate, fresh and chill.
I'm going to pass on that one.
Anything else exciting going on tonight?
Anything else exciting going on tonight?
Glub! Glub glub!
I can't go to an Aqua concert. I need to figure out what's going on.
Oh wow, an Aqua concert? Are they talking about the actual band Aqua? That's hilarious. Do you know where I can find Linda?
Do you know where I can find Linda?
Glubby? Glub glub! Glubby da glub! Da da glub glub!
Okay, and where did we used to spend time together?
The glub 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 glub.
The junkyard? Is that a bar? Anyway, I'll try to find it and see if she knows anything.
Did you hear something outside?
Did you hear something outside?
Glubby blub.
If you don't have ears, then how can you hear me?
Glubby da glub.
How can I understand you? Huh, good question.
That is a good question. You sure you don't know anything about that noise?
You sure you don't know anything about that noise? You think that was an explosion? Dear God!
Uh-oh. A fish actually rolled his eyes. Unbelievable. Next it'll be blinking.
Back.
Okay. Family photo.
A framed memory that I can't remember. Is that me in the picture?
I don't know, let's have a look at it.
Let's take a closer look. If that's me, then who is the other person? My mom, maybe?
Okay. Okay, I don't want to, like, take this glue.
Gotcha.
Oh, TV.
Your typical murder mystery.
Poster of
a
butler?
Everyone's a suspect, but you won't believe who did it.
Gasp, the butler did it.
I have better things to do than start redecorating.
Closure.
TV, anything on? Hello? Nope. Okay. Well, I think with him. The window?
Just a peaceful small town street. Except for that angry mob marching towards the town hall.
Oh.
Just a peaceful small town street. Except for that angry mob marching towards the town hall.
Can I change my clothes or anything? No. Can I take this card?
Happy birthday, fool. Honestly, we've had
your... Okay, we've read that. Anything around here? No. Oh, that...
The neighbor's house. Why is there a telescope pointing at my room?
Wait
what?
A minute. He must be a stargazer.
Yeah, he's definitely eyeing up something, that's for sure.
I think the decorations look fine as they are.
John Payne poster. Cities and Canes poster.
I have better things to do than start redecorating.
Coyotes.
Let's go, coyotes, let's go.
Memphis Beast poster.
My decorating services come at a price, and you can't afford it.
The Ghost Bakers.
I think the decorations look fine as they are.
Okay, let's leave now. Oh, no, not that. Turn television off. I guess we're like going to here. Hmm. Telephone, hello? Okay.
The line's dead. I can't call anyone.
Yeah, I haven't paid our phone bill. Recession and all that, you know? Yearbook? High school class?
Betty Anderson. I wish I wasn't an Anderson, because I'm always the first one to be called on. Linda Valentine. Individual picture? Why can't Betty be in it too? Wait, that fool's already taken hers? John Slim. With hair like this, who needs good grades? Dr. Dixon. As a scientist, I never cared about religion. That changed the day I met Miss Anderson. If there's a devil, then there has to be a god. Carrie Ann. See, Dad? I graduated without bribing the principal. Unlike you.
Bribing the principal?
Mr. Mr. Patel, your yearbook quote is due Friday. Greg Moore, I'm all for writing yearbook quotes, but my sister's not feeling well. Can I leave now? Mary W. Jackson, we won't reach the stars. Give me 20 years and I'll send you all packing to the moon. Bobby Lee, I swear I didn't bite the steel bar. Okay, I did, but it was asking for it. Ms. Peanut, yearbook quote, but I literally just got here. Sandy Moore, can we do this some other time? I think I need to go to the hospital. Joey Turner, no one makes a fool out of Joey Turner, except for Joey Turner. Joey Turner.
No one makes fun of Joey Turner.
Okay. I have better things to do than start redecorating.
Okay, well, let's head out then.
Time to go out and see the world. That's what I would say if the doorknob wasn't broken.
Well, let's fix it then.
The Betty Webster Dictionary of Excellence defines doorknob as a doorknob. Thanks for listening to my joke. There's no need for applause.
Okay. A doorknob. Betty's doorknob.
Time to go out and see the world. That's what I would say if the doorknob wasn't broken.
Okay. Hello.
And that, buddy, is how you combine items.
Mm-hmm.
Keep it in mind, would ya? I have a feeling we're gonna do this a lot.
Okay.
Time to go out and see the world. That's what I would say if the doorknob.
What are you talking about? My sticky doorknob.
A sticky doorknob, humanity's last chance of survival. And our only chance at continuing the game. So come on, let's get out of here already. Time to go out and see the world. That's.
Wait. I'm confused. I fixed that, didn't I? Did I not fix that?
Hey, if you mess family with my family, you mess with me.
Oh.
Yeesh. If I can't do something this easy without messing up, I foresee a long night ahead of us. Time to go out and see the world. That's what
I'm kind of confused then, Betty, because here I want to use it. There we go.
Time to go where no Betty has gone before. Well, not that I remember anyway.
But off to see the wizard. The wizard, the wizard, the wizard. Vote Eliza.
Eliza Barrett. You say corruption like it's a bad thing.
Okay.
Re-elect Mayor Barrett. If it ain't broke, don't swap horses. Eliza Barrett, you say corruption like it's a bad thing.
And garbage can? Oh no, look at the angry mob though. Let's go over and see what they're doing.
Hey guys, do you mind letting me through?
That depends. This is an angry mob. Are you angry?
Of course I'm angry!
Really? How angry are you?
The angriest. I guess, hello. Now that I think about it. Not much, just slightly irritated by the memory loss thing. Anger is not the answer. Yeah, I'm super angry!
Yeah, I'm super angry! Prove it.
Uh oh. Here we go then. Super angry.
Yeah, that's loud. But we're not sure it qualifies as angry.
Wait, what?
Keep practicing.
What about... Yeah!
Are you okay? Did you choke on something? You want to try that again?
Don't be rude. Grr.
Sounds more like you need a rabies shot.
Wait, what? You'll be angry enough by the time we reach. Don't you be bloody rude?
We're looking for angry people, not comic book villains. Keep practicing.
I think you're being very rude right now, madam. Say sorry.
That sounded like a muffled parrot. Keep at it. You want to try that again?
No.
This is really weird. I'm going to leave now. We're angry, not deaf.
Yeah, she's a weirdo, isn't she? Bloody weirdo.
You better have a tetanus shot ready for me if you want me to touch that.
What else do we have? Anya!
Ragazza, come in!
Uh-oh. He's from the mob.
Someone popped my memory. You wouldn't have something to do with all this, would you? Answer me, presto!
Let me go, I just wanted a trim. It's the end of the world, Barbara. Run for your life!
Don't waste your time with me! It's the end of the world! Run for your life, Barber!
No one ends the world without asking my permission first. Wait, Barber? When I find the Fachia Bruta responsible for all this, they will sleep with the fishes.
Okay, what would you do if I told you it was me? That'd be awful. That'd be an awful night's sleep if I snored like motorboats. With that attitude, nobody will want you to trim their beards.
With that attitude, nobody will want you to trim their beards.
Listen, I don't know if you're very brave or just very foolish, but you should be careful when talking with me. Because I trim more than just beards, believe me.
Oh, he is in the mob. He's a gangster.
I think I'd better let my hair grow long from now on.
Yep, no more shaving.
Free wigs, an offer you can't
refuse. Doing Japanese style.
Limited time only. Offer not valid in the state of Maine and the U.S. Virgin Islands. May not be combined with the free mustache coupon. Can't be used in the event of a bioweapon attack leading to an outbreak of a pandemic virus, transmitted via bites, or contact with bodily fluid that causes human corpses to reanimate and seek to consume living human flesh, blood, brain, or nerve tissue. That seems awfully specific.
Okay.
I'm sorry, I only collect posters of good movies. Mommy issues. An affliction far
mommy
more
issues.
Common than one would think.
The fuck? Do, 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 do. Statue?
Clearly, the artist wanted to express the nostalgic longing that screams deep within our hearts, reminding us of the fragile and ephemeral nature of our physical forms in this ever-accelerating modern capitalist society of ours. Or some punk just wanted to blow up a statue. What would I know?
Yep, one of the two. Ape Man.
I'm sorry, I only collect posters of good movies.
Uh-oh. Mr. Sheriff? And a veteran?
Looks like a veteran. I hope we won't be needing his expertise anytime soon. Finally! Someone with authority! He must know what's going on.
The veteran? Let's talk to the veteran.
Hey, in all the time I've been in charge, I've never left a case unsolved.
And how long's that been? An hour? Two. Less bragging and more looking into my case. I reckon I was someone of status, like a surgeon. So better hurry up, cause lives are at stake.
Sorry to interrupt, but are you the sheriff?
Yes, miss. Sheriff Amos Coltrane, here to protect and serve.
My name is Betty, and...
Pleasure. Name's Ben. Ben's in.
Ben's in. Surgeon.
Yep. See, Faco? This lady gets it.
Anyway, what can I help you with?
Well, with a lot, actually. Wait, how can you be so sure you're the sheriff?
The first thing I remember is sitting at my desk with my uniform on and my badge in my pocket. If I'm not the sheriff, then who else would I be?
Someone who killed a real sheriff and took his place? Someone who stole a uniform in a desperate attempt to pick up chicks? That's a belter. That's exactly what an imposter would say. someone really brave, because no one else would assume this position on a night like this. I think it would be someone who stole a uniform in a desperation attempt to pick up chicks.
Someone who stole a uniform in a desperate attempt to pick up chicks?
There's only so much a uniform can do.
True. Then maybe he owns a laundromat and he stole the uniform from the real sheriff.
Oh, my turn. Maybe he's one of them dancers that does bachelorette parties.
Enough with the stupid theories. I'm the sheriff and that's the end of the conversation. What else can I do for you?
Huh?
You said you needed help with a lot of things?
Oh yeah, that.
Did you know there's an angry mob in the streets? I need to report a missing person. Do you know the woman in this picture?
Do you know the woman in this picture?
Of course I do. It's you!
Oh my gosh, case closed.
Top sheriff?
I'm just messing with you. She's the mayor.
The mayor? What the? Do you know how many people have lost their memories?
Do you know how many people lost their memories?
So far, everyone that's come to me tonight seems to be suffering from some kind of amnesia, but...
Then it seems you've found the common denominator of the problem.
The top diggity dog.
That would happen? I have no clue.
Maybe you should work on that.
I appreciate the advice, young lady, but I think I know how to do my job. In fact, I've already done a lot of work on this case.
So, with all those things you've been doing...
What did the evidence tell you? The thought of calling for help, it didn't occur to you? What evidence did you get?
What did the evidence tell you?
Something blew up not far from here, but I haven't found where yet.
What kind of bomb was it?
The explosive kind.
The explosive kind? Okay. The thought of calling for help didn't occur to you?
The thought of calling for help didn't occur to you?
I can't. I only get static on the radio when I try to communicate with the outside. That's all you need to know.
Yeah, I can't communicate, hot diggity dog. How about driving to the nearest town? What about the things I don't need to know?
And what about the things I don't need to know?
Well, I found a box of 12 donuts.
Oh.
A bit stale, but I still ate them all. Oh, you meant about what's going on tonight.
Rude. I need to report a missing person.
I need to report a missing person.
Who are you looking for?
Your mama. My best friend forever, Linda. The most faithful steed that this town has ever known. Those sweet, the best steed.
The most faithful steed this town has ever known. My sparkly pink unicorn, Perdigon!
Sure, I'll get right on it. All you have to do is file your imaginary report and...
Hey, are you making fun of me?
Not at all. But in case you want to file a complaint, you can leave it in the box over there.
Damn right I will. Hey, that's a trash can.
Those 12 sweet and delicious donuts.
Those 12 sweet and delicious donuts.
The sheriff gobbled the dozen. Case closed.
Did you know there's an angry... Aww. Did you know there's an angry mob in the streets?
Did you know there is an angry mob in the streets?
I'll let Miss Mayor deal with that one.
Mr. Miss Mayor? That's a weird name.
Mr. Miss Mayor?
Anyway, there you go. I've got stuff to take care of.
Buying earplugs for the mayor's speech?
What speech?
The mayor is giving a speech at the town hall to address the situation. It should begin shortly.
Well, I better get going then.
Hot diggity dog.
Ben's in. The man closest to the sheriff. Literally.
Now, let's see here.
Is he gonna talk?
Is everything alright?
Everything is far from alright. I've lost my memory. All of it. And if getting back depends on that pig, I'll die memorylessly.
I'm warning you. One more insult and I'll put you in the darkest cell I can find.
Uh-oh.
Even if you could find that cell, I'd be more useful from there than you are right now.
I'm looking for a friend. Her name's Linda. What do you think happened to our memories?
What do you think happened to our memories?
If you ask my opinion, I would say witchcraft.
Oh.
This doesn't look like witchcraft to me, Ben.
Witchcraft?
Witches or not, you must agree that the sheriff's level of incompetence is supernatural. Supernatural.
Yeah, it's almost superstitious.
Don't force me to detain you.
Detain me? I ain't even moving. Anyway, I suggest we keep an eye out. We don't want them witches eating our brains.
Those are zombies, Ben.
Oh, sweet Jesus! Zombies too?
I'm looking for a friend. Hey, Ben, I hate to break it to you, but I'm pretty sure you've only been in the hospital once.
Hey, Ben, hate to break it to you, but I'm pretty sure you've only been in the hospital once. And that was the day you were born.
You couldn't be wrong. I really feel pretty literate. I'm sure I have some kind of a PhD.
Yes, judging by your fragrance, a PhD in hydrocarbons.
Hydro what?
Hilarious. I'm looking for a friend. Her name's Linda.
I'm looking for a friend. Her name is Linda. Have you seen her?
I guess I could tell you what I know, but it's gonna cost you.
Reva? My mom might be Mia. You want me on your side? I have ways to get information out of you. There's no time to be worrying about money. What do you want? I have ways to get information out of you.
Ways to get the information out of you.
No money, no talking.
What if I slap it out of you?
Uh-oh.
How's that for a currency?
No need to get violent, lady. I saw her headed toward the junkyard there at the end of the street.
So, talk to you later.
Whenever you want, if you're not a commie.
A commie? Okay. Don't be a commie. Oh.
Now let's see here. My man's just going to you get two.
A beautiful selection of ripe, tasty, and suspiciously cheap fruit. Who can stay in business with prices like these?
Now let's see here.
A broccoli a day keeps Betty away. I'm pretty sure I love Twonkies.
Twonkies?
Person, but that one is going to be hard to chew.
Not Twinkies, it's Twonkies.
Now let's see here. My man's just gonna get the two.
What's little Twinkies.
It's where I have ideas.
What does Twinkies taste like? I heard they're like soft and creamy in the center.
Did yourself this time, Linda. If that's even your real name, how am I gonna get out of here?
Oh, Linda's repair. What is this place?
This could do a lot of damage.
Hey, who's there?
Uh-oh.
I need help.
Hey, I'm busy. On ya. Oh, no, on ya. Ignore.
Okay, don't help me. I got this.
I'm busy. I'm doing something right now. I'm trying to see what's in your scrapyard.
Just me, or is it kind of hot in here?
Uh-oh. What are you doing?
I can't. I think I'm gonna...
Linda? What happened?
Linda? I don't know if I should tell the mayor or the guy at the police station, but I think Linda needs some help.
Oh, damn it, Linda. Keep out, sane. Big pile of junk. Cat hood. Junkyard. Okay.
Stuck. I don't think I will be able to open it on my own.
Well, let's use a crane.
Let's stop messing around and get Linda some help, okay? Let's stop messing around and get Linda some help, okay?
Okay. Officer! There's a lady in trouble. She's fell over.
How's the night going, Citizen Coltrane?
Good evening, Citizen Betty.
You have to get to the junkyard right now. There's someone trapped in the workshop.
Rest assured, this person will be rescued.
I'll leave you doing, whatever you're doing, Mr. Coltrane.
Good. Finally, some peace and quiet.
Ray, couldn't help her then?
I think the sheriff's got this covered. We should go see the mayor.
Okay. Where's the mayor?
I'm pretty sure I love Twonkies as much as the next person, but that one is going to be hard to chew.
Okay. I guess we're going by the way then. Mr. Baguette. Don't forget, Mr. Baguette. Freshly baked. Park gate. Open!
Why is this locked? Did someone try to steal the trees or something?
Yeah, I was cutting them down. So we can have pencils and toilet paper. Then die, because the trees are not collecting carbon monoxide anymore. And all the bees are dying.
Who stole our memories?
Even angrier mob? Uh-oh, that's not good, is it?
Guys, the doors are opening! Finally, some answers! That can't be the mayor!
He must be an intern.
He's too old to be an intern. Wait, he's grabbing something.
Oh, wow.
Is that a mop?
He's a janitor?
Why would the mayor be holding a mop?
Fellow citizens, I am Mayor Eliza Barrett. We are currently faced with an unprecedented crisis. Our identities, and worse, our memories, were stolen from us through unknown means. I understand that this is cause for alarm, but I want you all to rest assured that there is nothing more important to me than the safety of my fellow citizens. And seeing that each and every one of you can claim back what is rightfully yours.
Uh-oh. Well, it looks like we got nothing to worry about, right, guys? She's got it all under control. Let's put the barber in charge. I don't know about you guys, but I've heard enough. I don't know about you guys, but I've heard enough.
I don't know about you guys, but I've heard enough.
She's right. We should hang her.
Wait.
Oh, it's a bit extreme.
No way. What are we, savages?
Gotta burn the witch.
Uh-oh.
And then we hang her.
I think that's my mom.
Anyone.
Witch sympathizer.
We will take immediate action and tackle this crisis head on. Our first objective shall be to reestablish contact with the outside world. I have absolute confidence that together we will overturn the situation and get everything back under control in less than 24 hours.
Alright guys, time to pack your things. Under control! Where have I heard that one before? 24 hours isn't that long? She's expropriating our land, raising our taxes, burning our fields. Alright guys, time to pack our things.
Alright guys, time to pack our things.
Make the mob angry.
Tomorrow, everything will be
fine. Like, we're not packing!
What if it isn't? Then we will return as an even angrier mob! And if that doesn't work either,
then we transcend the limits of the angry mob.
Uh-oh.
We shall become a furious mob. See if they can handle that.
And what if... Shut up! Stop asking questions we don't have the answers to.
That will be all for now.
That's all? We go home and wait?
Your authority isn't recognized in... Wait, what's the name of this town again?
It's the mayor! I don't think she's coming out again.
I was looking at the window. Oh my god, I'm climbing in the window.
Who are you, and what are you doing in my office?
I got... I asked you I was looking
question,
for...
young lady.
I was looking for the toilet.
I feel a chill down my spine whenever she looks at me. Is it because she's the mayor? Or my mom?
You should not be here. Get out now.
Wait, what? That is so rude. Don't talk to your daughter like that. Say sorry.
That's right, Fossil. Back by popular demand, it's Betty!
Are you seriously just going to keep wasting my time?
Mummy? Mummy, what are you doing, Mummy? Hello, I'm the mayor.
Hello, I'm the mayor. Please leave my office at once.
Your office? This is my office. I am the mayor.
You're the mayor. Prove it.
My name is on the door.
That only proves it's your door, not your office.
Look at yourself. You could never be the mayor.
Of course I could.
Could? See, you just confessed. You cannot keep your story straight.
Damn it! I'll see myself out.
Wait, knock, knock. Am I?
Back. Did you miss me?
I have already said everything I had to say.
But Mummy. Mummy, so you think it looks like rain? Hi, I'm the Vice Mayor.
Hi, I'm the Vice Mayor.
Not you again.
Mummy. Knock, knock.
I know you don't want me in here, but I have something to do. I just can't remember what.
Do you really not have better things to do?
Not really, Mummy, no. Miss Mayor Betty B. Bettison from the Going Gray Herald.
Miss Mayor Betty B. Bettison from the Going Gray Herald. A few questions, if I may.
No comment.
Well, you just lost your chance to be on the cover of a magazine.
Well, since you came all the way here, let me give you a headline. Security!
Knock, knock.
Where is security when you need them?
Let's not answer that. Right, so you think it looks like rain? I'm in charge of recruitment for our sorority. Handy Betty's telephone repair service, a budget for every need.
Handy Betty's telephone repair service, a budget for every need.
The only thing I need right now is for you to get out of my office.
Well, that's gonna be pretty pricey.
Speaking of prices, wait until you see the fine for trespassing.
I came all this way! I'm going to charge you for the consult at least.
Do not worry. Security is coming with your check.
I appreciate the check, but maybe you could just mail it to me.
Knock, knock. I'm back, Mummy. Mummy.
Not have better things to do.
Okay. You've done it now. So you think it looks like rain?
So you think it looks like rain?
Oh, would you like a weather report? Strong security winds from the south will blow you right out the door. Oh, and there is a 50% chance of a flurry of punches.
I don't like this forecast. I'd better go find shelter.
Knock, knock. Mummy.
Where is security when you need them?
They're on vacation. Sorry to bother you, but I was trying to find a bathroom and got separated.
Sorry to bother you, but I was trying to find the bathroom and got separated from my group.
This is Town Hall, not a museum, young lady.
Whoa, a talking mummy? This is the best museum ever.
Let me point you to the exit.
Oh, look, there's my group. Bye-bye. Pleasure meeting you.
I think it's too soon for a January 6th joke. Knock, knock. Mummy.
I have already said everything I had to say.
No, you haven't. Explain yourself. I'm in charge.
I'm in charge of recruitment for our sorority.
My sorority years are behind me.
Oh, that's okay. In Alpha Delta Pi, age is just a number.
The amount of time you would face in prison for breaking and entering is also just a number.
Good point. Let's keep it that way.
Finally, knock knock. Mummy. I have something important.
Give up.
No, I've got something important to tell you. You have any lesson? I have a candygram for one Eliza Barrett. I have to see it.
I have a candygram for one Eliza Barrett. From a secret admirer.
I do not do secret admirers.
With a personality like that, no wonder.
Wow. Okay, we'll do the right answer this time. That's funny. Mummy.
Where is security when you need them?
I have something important to tell you.
I have something important to tell you. I think we're family!
I thought you said it was important. Let me see that.
See? You can't deny the resemblance. I think you're my mom.
You think the mere assumption that I'm your mother entitles you to break into my office?
Yes?
What do you want anyway?
I just want to know what's really going on. And, you know, I thought we could maybe work together? Mother and daughter on a mission kind of thing?
Whether we are related or not is irrelevant. Everything that needed to be said, I already addressed in my speech earlier. What more is there to know?
I don't know. You tell me.
What was the explosion that woke me up? Why does no one remember anything? Where's my dad?
Where's my dad?
Your progenitor has no bearing on this conversation.
So, no happy family reunion?
No. Now, if you don't mind, I have an antenna to fix.
An antenna?
The generator that powers it is broken. With the telephone lines down, fixing it is our best shot at making a distress call.
I see. Maybe I can help you with that.
That will not be necessary. The sheriff and I will handle the situation.
Are you sure it's wise to trust the sheriff with electrical repairs? You trust sheriff more than you trust your own daughter?
Are you sure it's wise to trust the sheriff with electrical repairs?
He claims to be proficient in the matter, although his choice of tools does leave me uncertain. What do clothes hangers, bubble gum, and tinfoil have to do with repairing electrical appliances?
Absolutely nothing, which is why he's not the right person for the job. Ooh, but my friend Linda is. She's a mechanic. I'm sure she could sort you out.
Is that so? Perhaps you will not be as useless as I had anticipated.
Thanks.
Okay, listen. The generator is located near the southwest entrance of the park. I need your friend to inspect it and repair the malfunction.
What's in it for me?
Did you just not offer to help? Never mind. What do you want?
I want some kind-hearted words of motherly love. To call you mummy, a family hug, a warmer welcome. Some kind-hearted words of motherly love.
Some kind-hearted words of motherly love?
You mean something along the lines of, good morning, honey. Did you sleep well? Here, have some pancakes.
Yeah, exactly that.
Let us make a deal. You procure the mechanic's help, and then I will see about granting that request of yours.
Jackpot! Off I go, Mom. I won't let you down.
The barber and the offer he couldn't refuse.
Protection payment? What protection payment?
The one preventing us from wasting this place.
Who are you again? And who am I? Everything is so confusing.
For the third time, my name is Marco De Luca, and my patience is running low, ragazza.
I've lost my memory. How do I know I haven't paid already?
That's a very nice tool set you got there, ragazza. Move. Yeah, this will do. If you want it back, bring what you owe to my associate at the mansion. With juice.
Wait, you can't just...
Pleasure doing business with you, Miss Valentine.
Hey, you! What was that in there?
Rude.
Mammoth? What's the matter? Cat got your tongue?
What's wrong? Cat got your tongue?
You have done it now.
Hey, Linda, are you okay? Wait a second. I know that voice. Oh, fantastic. If it isn't the fool that left me hanging before.
Hey, I sent the sheriff, didn't I?
Anyway, who the rusty hell are you?
I've been looking for you. I thought you might know what's going on. Or at least remember me.
Why would I?
Long story short, I'm your best friend, Betty.
You and I? Friends? You're joking, right?
I'm not joking. I found a birthday card from you.
You wrote how lucky you are to have me in your life.
That doesn't sound like me. I wouldn't miss a chance to call you a fool.
Ouch! How did you... Well, never mind. That's spot on. We're friends, no doubt. You got any idea what that guy wanted from you?
That Rhino Co. goon took my toolbox.
Well, it could have been worse.
I'm a mechanic. How am I supposed to work without my tools?
Eh, you'll figure it out. In the meantime, I need your help fixing a generator.
Haven't you listened to a word I said?
Yes. Anyway.
The mayor is my mother. Can you believe that?
The mayor is my mother. Can you believe that?
The mayor, huh? You think you could ask her to get my tools back?
Mm-hmm.
And disappoint her even further with this mess? No, thanks.
Great. And here I thought you could be helpful.
How'd you end up stuck in here?
Well, you're not gonna believe it, but here I was, trying to figure out who I am when, all of a sudden, before I could even realize what was going on, I was surrounded by five of them.
Five of what?
Mariachi... ninjas? Yeah, that!
Oh my god! Mariachi ninjas?!
Yeah, five ninjas with guitars and sombreros.
Linda...
All right. I was trying to find the light switch and I sneezed, hit my head, tripped, fell on my back, and somehow managed to get the door stuck. Happy now?
Tell you what, I'll deal with that guy and you help me fix the generator.
Tell you what, I'll deal with that guy and you help me fix the generator. How does that sound? All I need to know is what I'm looking for. Can you describe it to me?
Tall, dark, and handsome. Enjoys long walks on the beach, classical music, and wants to travel the world before taking over its father's multinational company. Oh yeah, it's also a box with tools in it.
Sounds like the most eligible toolbox in town.
Instead of playing hero, why don't you just report it to the sheriff and see where that goes?
Yeah, you're right. Talking with the sheriff might be the best course of action.
All right. But be careful, okay?
Oh, look at you, all worried about me.
Oh, shut up. I'm already regretting this.
I'd better get going. But before I go, I just have one question. Have you ever tried being nice?
Yeah, once in the summer of 1942. Worst 3 seconds of my life.
Worst 3 seconds?
I don't know much about cars, but this is gorgeous.
Have a look around.
Chef Mike's, I can't believe it's not paint.
I can't believe it looks like paint. No, what is it? I can't believe it's paint. It looks like paint. It feels like paint. But it's not paint. It's better.
I have no idea who this handsome fella is.
Me neither. But I can feel him glaring at me whenever I stack boxes.
I don't think Linda would like that.
Take it? Why not?
Stockman's Cowabunga Wax. You scratch it, we hide it. Car giving you trouble? Come on over to Linda's Repair and watch her smash your troubles away.
Oh.
50% discount for first-time customers.
Okay.
Do I look like a lawyer to you? It's some kind of rental agreement.
Ah, some pizza. Have a little slice of Linda's pizza. Oh no.
Let's leave the chit chat for later.
Okay. What happened to your window? Who done it? Was that gangster, wasn't it?
I don't know much about cars, but this is gorgeous. Where would I go with it?
Whatever you like. You can go wherever you want.
I don't think I've been trained to operate heavy machinery. Or have I? No, Betty, stop. Resist the siren call of the junkyard crane.
Resist.
This car seems remarkably salvageable for a piece of junk. It's just a big pile of junk. I wouldn't want to be here when her mom finds out. Urgent service, no matter how long it takes.
Okay, let's head out. Do do do. There's a lady here now. Oh. Floods.
Finally, someone came to talk to me. I've been dying for some chit chat.
Okay. By the way, who are you?
Lorraine, my dear.
Nice to meet you, Lorraine. I'm Betty.
I was waiting on your opening name, Betty. Hey, Lorraine, can you help me with something? Everyone in town seems to be having trouble with their memories.
Everyone in town seems to be having trouble with their memories.
Oh, that's not possible. Everyone, you say. My memory is crystal clear.
What's the first thing you can, do you know what your family is? Do you remember your customers' names? What's the first thing you can recall?
What's the first thing you can recall?
Tonight? I've been here the whole time.
And before that, do you remember anything?
Well, of course I do, hun. Don't be silly. This morning, I...
See? You can't remember either.
Do you remember your customers' names?
Do you remember your customers' names?
Of course! You're Betty!
Yeah, I just told you that a while ago. But do you remember the sheriff's name, for example?
The sheriff? His name is, dear, I think my memory isn't what it used to be.
I don't think it's an age-related issue. There's something weird going on.
Age-related? How old do you think I am?
I don't know, between 70 and death?
Really? That old? What did I do with my life? Ah, oh, so many missed opportunities.
Yeah, you could've.
You've got your tomatoes and your bananas are overpriced. Your bananas should be actually 1 cent and your tomatoes, it should be 3 cents. Okay. Indulge in more intellectual activities.
Indulged in more intellectual activities.
Yes! I could have been the first to find the Holy Grail, Excalibur, and the Fountain of Youth. Then, with all of them in my hands, I could have become the new ruler of the world.
Oh.
Forever.
I was thinking more along the lines of starting a small home library or something, but okay.
Shush! I think there's still time to go through with this. Follow me and I'll knight you. You shall be known as Betty of the Unforeseen Talents.
Unforeseen Talents.
I'll follow you everywhere, my liege. But if I may beg for a simple request, my service to you shall be eternal.
Speak your mind.
I would humbly beg of thee to ban the distribution of broccoli.
Tough but fair. Very well, I shall grant your wish.
Oh, wow.
Thank you. For that, you shall be known as Queen Lorraine, Vanquisher of Broccoli.
Vanquisher of Broccoli? Really? Lorraine's high-priced fruits? Everyone in town seems to be having trouble with their memories. A beautiful display you have here, Lorraine. Hey, Lorraine, can you help me? Beautiful display.
Beautiful display you have here, Lorraine.
Thank you. But there is one thing that makes me uneasy.
Yeah?
Well, the fact that you don't sell cherimoyas is concerning.
What is concerning is that you know what a cherimoya is. But anyway, it's not that. Haven't you noticed? The display is full of military crates.
You're right. Where do you think you got them?
No idea. But the basement is full of them.
Oh.
Perhaps you should keep away from the basement until we know more of what's going on.
Everyone in town seems to be having trouble with their memories.
Everyone in town seems to be having trouble with their memories.
Oh, that's not possible. Everyone, you say.
Mm-hmm.
My memory is crystal clear.
Do you know where your family is?
Do you know where your family is?
Oh, of course I do. Don't be silly. My family is... they are...
I don't remember where I was going with this anymore. Let's change the subject.
Can you help me with something, Lorraine?
Hey, Lorraine, can you help me with something?
Sure, hon. What seems to be the trouble?
I'm looking for this big fella.
I'm looking for this big fella.
Bigfoot.
Nice suit, angry face, carrying a toolbox.
I saw that man just a while ago. He was talking with that barber over there.
Uh-oh.
I'll be seeing you.
See you soon, Betty.
Bye, Lorraine. Okay, well, I'm gonna leave it here for this part. Let me know what you think about this game. Oh my god, you got a grenade. So yeah, let me know what you think about this game down in the comments section. And yeah, don't forget to like, comment, share and subscribe. Tell your friends and tell your family. It's absolutely free and doesn't cost anything. And as always, take it easy. Have a good one and goodbye!